Hello, my celestial Scorpios, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. This is Mystic Storm here to clear a path to a new life with you. If you're new, welcome to the family and soul tribe. I pray that this message resonates with you and that you're able to gain guidance, encouragement, and inspiration to go through this week, okay? And I will invite you to check out the weekly essences. They're intuitive guidance reading where we dive into astrology, and back that up with tarot and oracle, okay? So if you want to know more about the energies that are surrounding this week, go tune in, okay? But let's go ahead and talk about you, my Scorpio, okay? So I went into a brief meditation and the color that I seen for you was red. And the message I got was torn and divided. Torn and divided. So I feel like the red is here for you to work with your root chakra in order for you to gain a decision or make a decision. I feel like you probably are in like a two of swords type energy at a crossroad and you don't know which way to turn. So, but if you get grounded, you'll be able to gain guidance on which path to take that will ultimately lead you to your abundant life, okay? So let's jump into the cards. We have the Psychic Tarot. Spirit, what messages, what guidance do you have for my Scorpios? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus for this week. What is the crowning energy? Why are they so torn and divided? Okay. I've seen that. Intuition was in reverse. Okay. Solitude. Okay. Solitude in reverse with intuition in reverse as well. I'm going to take this one. Okay. So you're torn and divided because you might be surrounding yourself with the wrong people or surrounding yourself or taking in or listening to things that aren't high vibrational. You might be reading articles that are bringing you back down, low vibrational. You might be watching certain content that will bring you down to a low vibrational level. You might be hanging out with the wrong type of friends, you know, wrong people. You might need to change it up, switch it up. Be in solitude. Figure out what it is that you need to do in order to go forth, in order to make this decision that you need to make. Intuition in reverse, you're not really following your intuition, the guidance that you have inside of you, your internal compass on what you need to do in order to go forth, okay? That's why you're being indecisive, all right? So yeah, definitely going into hermit mode, going within, learning more about yourself, studying more, okay? Tapping in and trusting your intuition more. It's just as simple as before you make any decision, any small decision, I will say, you can practice this. Small decisions, like if you want to wear blue or green today, and you stop and you go within and say, what color should I wear today? And you hear blue, and you wear blue, and that helps you some way. Or if you have multiple routes to go to your destination, you stop and think, which route should I take today? And if you hear one route and you take it, it should be a smooth ride. Or if you neglect that, you might run into some traffic, multiple detours. So working on intuition techniques and practices to build that up, okay? All right, let's continue. Base chakra here. In reverse, yeah. Like I said, you need to work with your base chakra to ground your root chakra to ground and be more secure so you can make the decisions that you want in life. Spiritual strength. Yes. Know that you can endure. Know that you have all the tools you need to make the decisions you need to make in order to go forth, okay? You're stronger than what you're letting yourself out to be, and you need to tap into that. That is what's going to be fulfilling for you to trusting your intuition and trusting your guidance in order for you to have the path to your new life be clear in order for you to keep going, okay? All right. We're going to get into the, I was about to say sacral chakra, okay, but the chakra insight oracle. If the sacral chakra pops out, that might be a message as well. Let's see. What chakra should my Scorpios work with? What do they need to know? Whoa. I keep seeing that sacral chakra desire. It keep wanting to come out. But this is what you got. Insight. Okay? This is tapping into your intuition. All right? It's saying understanding, awakening, awareness, self-evaluation. So if you work with your intuition, you'll gain the insight you need in order to go forth, okay? You'll awaken a part of you that has been dormant for a long time, and this will upgrade you, okay, into your spiritual strength. Again, you're stronger than what you set yourself out to be, and I'm just looking at that ring of purple here, lining up with that insight here, okay? Beautiful energy. You might need to meditate more. Meditation does help with intuition. Even if you meditate for a minute or just stop and work on breath work just for a minute, you can be anywhere. You don't necessarily have to be in your meditation corner or, you know, anything like that. You can be at work and take time to meditate and be aware of how you feel. Be aware of the energy that is surrounding you, okay? All right. Let's get into the soul cards next. Let's see what your soul is calling you to be aware of. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Scorpios? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Messages, guidance for my Scorpios. Interesting. It's the three fish here, and only one is pointing this direction, and two are pointing that way. So even though you may see with your physical eye that this may be the right path because you see signs, quote unquote signs, if you trust your mind's eye that will be illuminated, it will show you the correct direction. Your physical eyes, your other senses might be leading you another way, but if you're tapped into your intuition, it will tell you no. This is the correct way to go. Those other ones are distractions and traps, okay? So, yeah, definitely work on your intuition this week, because you might dodge some bullets, okay? All right, and we're going to get into the final message from the Whispers of the Ocean. But before we do, I do invite you to like, share, comment, subscribe. Click that notification bell so you can continue to get content from this beautiful, growing, insightful, and loving channel. Thank you so much. I love you all. All right, what's the final message for my Scorpios? Final message for my Scorpios. This one. Setting up parameters. This is boundaries, okay? Assess your relationships and determine how they are aligned with your goals. Setting boundaries require an honest evaluation of your present relationships. Didn't I say you might be hanging out with some people that, you know, probably aren't in your best interest, that are low vibrational? Setting up parameters, setting firm boundaries. And it's talked about setting boundaries require an honest evaluation, and we have self-evaluation here. So with you going within, you will know that, yeah, these people might be leading you down the wrong path, okay? But you have to trust your intuition and know you have to go the other way, okay? Don't depend on other people to tell you what choices you need to make in life. You trust yourself. You develop that relationship within yourself to know what moves you need to make, okay? Okay, so this is what we have, my Scorpios. I hope you all enjoyed and that it gave you guidance and strength to go through this week. I love you all, and I hope you have a wonderful week, and I'll see you in a next one. Bye.